I thought we might take a little drive out by the reservoir. You know, the full moon.
Now, you know I have to be at work in the morning.
Oh, couldn't you be a little late? People buy dresses in the afternoon, too.
But the boss has to set the other girls an example.
Just a short drive?
Well, all right, Throckmorton. But you'll have to wait a minute. I promised Mother I'd pick up a prescription.
Yeah, well, don't be too long.
I'll be right back. After all, we don't want to keep that moon working overtime.
Would you mind holding this?
That's it. You have much trouble keeping these in repair?
Yeah, they give me trouble all the time. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Good night. Good night.
See? All ready and waiting.
And so am I. To learn to be more tolerant, Bessie. This is a sleepy little town with a lot of sleepy little people. But don't worry, he won't get away with it for long. Some of us are on our toes around here.
You want to dictate now or read the paper?
I'll call you when I'm ready, Bessie. Cut yourself?
Oh, no, sir.
Commissioner Gildersleeve in his office?
Yes, sir. He's on the job.
Gildersleeve.
Oh, good morning, Mr. Mayor.
Gildersleeve, are you on the job?
Oh, yes. Just collecting my thoughts for the day.
I see.
I was surveying the local scene.
Well, just so you get your job done.
Oh, yes, sir. Have a chair, Mr. Mayor.
See here, Gildersleeve. There's a crisis in Summerfield. This whistling bandit has turned up at a very unfortunate time.
Well, I don't suppose those fellows are ever very welcome.
Well, as it happens, Police Commissioner Armstrong is at a fishing lodge. He's somewhere up in the back country. We haven't been able to locate him.
Well, that eliminates him as a possible suspect.
Oh, Gildersleeve, you're a great comfort to me. But that isn't why I'm here. Now, if word gets around that we're without a police commissioner and at a time when there's a bandit loose in our midst, the people are very apt to panic. Get excited. It's only a possibility. But to prevent it, I've suggested you as the logical one to be put in charge of Commissioner Armstrong's department.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you for your confidence in me. I stand ready to shoulder my responsibility and protect my fellow citizens.
Wait a minute. Wait, now that's exactly what I don't want. Now, Gildersleeve, you get this straight. This is a job in name only. Now, there's going to be an announcement in the paper. But don't you let it go to your head. If there are any inquiries, you refer them to Lieutenant Finley at police headquarters.
Mr. Mayor, I'm a public servant. You can tie my hands and tie my feet, but you can't stop this from working. It'll be ticking every minute of the day.
Sure. But in the meantime, you remember what I told you. Now, the city council doesn't expect anything of you. Don't surprise them.
Bessie, come in here a moment. Whistling bandit, indeed. Jesse, phone Lieutenant Finley at police headquarters. Tell them I want an R&I, an APB, mugshots, and any other dope they've got in the Whistling Bandit. Now, get going. I hate crooks.
Oh, Jesse, when you get Lieutenant Finley, ask him if he's got another badge.
Yes, sir.
What do you know
about this? Levi! Yeah,
Bertie? Your uncle's name is in the paper.
Yeah?
Boy, someday you're gonna go right through that floor.
What's your uncle up to?
Your uncle's been appointed police commissioner.
Police commissioner?
How about that? I sure hope they know what they're doing.
Hi, Al.
Leroy, my boy.
Good evening, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Bertie.
It's wonderful news, you being appointed police commissioner.
Yes, yes.
How come you look so grim?
Grim work, Bertie, wearing another man's harness.
It's in the evening paper.
Oh, it is? Let's have a look.
It's the same as the one you got there in your pocket. I'm saving this one for a souvenir.
Police commissioner, how about that? I guess it's pretty rough work, Unc.
All in the line of duty, my boy.
Isn't that something, Leroy? Your uncle's gonna be chief of police.
Commissioner Bertie, it's just for a few days. Nothing to get excited about. Here, my boy, run down to the corner and see if the newsboy has a few extra copies.
You bet. I'm ready. Yes, sir.
Well, I'll get it, Bertie.
Yes, sir.
Commissioner Gildersleeve speaking.
This is Lois Throckmorton. Relax.
Oh, hello, Lois.
I just called to congratulate the new police commissioner. You're still water commissioner, too, aren't you?
Oh, yes, of course.
Well, now, you haven't forgotten your promise about the pictures tomorrow. It'll make a wonderful publicity tie-in. Water commissioner judges latest fashions in beachwear.
Well, I haven't forgotten, but now that I'm police commissioner, I'm not sure it's dignified.
Oh, now, Throckmorton, we're bringing the photographer over from the Summerfield Clarion.
It'll only take a few minutes.
Well, I will be busy. Two jobs and all.
Throckmorton, there'll be models in those bathing suits.
Well, I'm a fine time. My office, about, three-ish?
Wonderful. Bye.
Ta-ta, Lois.
Excuse me, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Yes, Bertie?
What would the police and water commissioner like for his dinner?
Oh, I'm not very hungry. Anything at all, Bertie.
But you got to eat for two now.
What's that?
Representing the strong arm of the law.
You're good, my boy.
I can't wait to tell all the kids my uncle's police commissioner. Better than that, I think I'll be your junior assistant.
Yeah, that's fine. Run along, my boy.
Give up, you crook! Back! Back!
Hey, Roy! On this badge won't open.
Is that why you called me, Mr. Gildersleeve?
Certainly not, Lieutenant. Time is running out. We've got to get to the bottom of this Whistling Bandit matter.
Well, the department's working on it. Didn't the mayor explain? There's really nothing for you to do.
If you're going to get ahead in this world, you've got to do a little more than you're asked to do.
Yes, sir.
Bessie, will you come in here? Bessie, you're a woman. Use your wiles on this and start.
There's a man outside to see you.
Oh, who?
Well, he didn't give me his name. Just said it was personal and important.
Yeah, I can't see him now. I've got a case to crack. Ask him to wait.
Yes, sir.
Now, Finley, as I said.
Well, here we are, Throckmorton, right on time.
Hello, Lois.
Melinda and Carol, this is Throckmorton P. Gildersleeve, our double threat man, commissioner of the water department and the police.
Hi, cutie pie.
Hello, you.
How do you do, ladies? May I take your coats?
And this is Mr. Conklin, our photographer from the Clarion.
Mr. Conklin?
Pleasure.
Mr. Conklin? Ladies? This is Lieutenant Finley of the Summerfield Police Department.
Oh,
Oh, how exciting. I hope we're not intruding on official business.
Not at all.
Well, we won't take up too much of your time. Mr. Coughlin, would you please get set up now?
All right. Girls, stand over by the window and put the commissioner in the middle.
You?
You won't be needing me, Mr. Gildersleeve, so I'll go on my coffee break.
Yeah, all right, Bessie, but don't be gone too long. The lieutenant and I have a case to crack, remember?
Commissioner Gildersleeve is in a conference, but you can wait if you like.
Well, he helped me out the other night, and I thought I'd return the favor.
Oh, how nice. The clasp on this badge is stuck. Are you good with your fingers?
I've had some success. Perhaps I can help.
Thank you. I'm going out for coffee. I'll be right back.
Don't hurry.
Right in front of this map of the Summerfield water system. You know, water, that was the whole idea.
Okay, Miss Kimball. Girls, bring the commissioner up here in front of the map.
Yeah. You'd better make up your mind, Lois. After all, we're spending the taxpayers' money.
Oh, don't be such an old grouch, Commissioner. I'm a taxpayer, too.
Me too, Commissioner.
Hadn't thought of that.
Let's try one over here behind the desk.
Hey, Lois, will you please make up your mind?
Lieutenant, are they expecting the whistling bandit to strike again?
I'm afraid that's the way it figures, Miss Kimball.
I wouldn't count on that, Lieutenant. Now that he knows that I'm on the job, he probably won't be within a million miles of here.
Oh. Smile.
It's a pretty noisy camera, Mr. Cameron.
We never did that before. Oh, more like nitro.
Nitro? Bessie, don't touch anything.
Yes, sir.
The crime lab will want to dust for fingerprints.
Yes, sir. Oh, Mr. Gildersleeve.
What'll the mayor say when he hears about this?
Well.
He leaves me in charge and I failed him.
Yes, sir.
Hello, Commissioner.
Finley, have you seen the mayor?
He's not in his office. His secretary told me to expect him later in the day.
Oh, my.
Hello, Bessie. Well, Commissioner, you've put the department in quite a spot. This isn't going to be very good publicity for us.
Well, it isn't good publicity for me, either.
Oh, it is for me. The newspapers were here. They took our picture.
Bessie!
That's twice today you've had your picture taken. They'll probably give the first one the biggest coverage. I can see it now. You with your arms around those two girls in the bathing suits and your eyes popping out of your head. The caption will probably read, Bandit Robs Water Department While New Commissioner Whistles.
Thank you, Bessie. My first day as police commissioner, and I make a monkey out of myself.
Yes, sir. If you'll excuse me, Mr. Gildersleeve, Lieutenant Finley wants me to come over to his office and look at the mug book and see if I recognize the man.
Run along, Bessie. I've got to get my hands on that mug.
Hey, where I'll find the acting police commissioner?
Yeah, yes, that's me. Throckmorton P. Gildersleeve.
My name is Henry J. Rafferty. I'd like to talk to you, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Sit right down here, Mr. Rafferty.
Thank you.
Have we met before?
No, I went to an Eastern school.
No.
Will your secretary be gone for long?
Oh, yes.
Good.
She went down to Lieutenant Finley's office. They're checking on fingerprints and pictures, routine things like that.
If you're referring to the recent series of robberies, I'm afraid they won't find any fingerprints.
What's that?
The whistling bandit never leaves prints. He always wears gloves.
You seem to know a good deal about the man.
Well, I should. I've been one step behind him for years. That's what I came to talk to you about, Mr. Gildersleeve. I'm a licensed investigator. My credentials.
Oh, I have one like that.
Have you? Let's get down to business. Now, I worked on the big Burlington robbery last year.
They never did get that guy, did they?
Nope. I see you're the cautious type.
Well, man can't be too careful, you know.
I got that from the head of the Burlington Detective Bureau.
Yeah, they must have thought a lot of you.
They learned to respect me.
Mr. Rafferty, I have a good idea. How would you like to help me catch the Whistling Bandit?
Well, that's a pretty big order. But I did come here to volunteer my services.
Good. I'll call Lieutenant Finley and tell him I've hired a private detective.
Just a minute. Don't call the police.
Why not?
Wouldn't you like to get all the credit, Commissioner?
You're pretty clever, Rafferty.
I think so.
Now, just how do we go about catching this crook?
Well, he generally follows one job with another job.
He does? No, thank you.
What's the biggest bank in town?
Why, that'd be the State Bank.
If I know the Whistling Bandit, that's where he'll be tonight.
Why don't you and I set a trap for him?
Think you can get us in the bank after dark?
Well, it might be a little difficult getting the keys and all. But I'll find a way. After all, I'm the police commissioner. Hello, Petey. Have you got anything to still the nerves?
Well, I might have.
Well, I may need it. I'm going after that bandit tonight.
You don't say.
I mean it, Petey. Look at this.
Hi. I'd like to take you home and show you to Miss Peavy.
No, I wouldn't have time, Peavy.
Miss Gildersleeve, do you mind putting that gun away?
Oh, I haven't loaded it yet, Peavy. Must have been one left in the barrel.
That'll be $5, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Peavy, you aren't going to charge me $5.
Well, now, I wouldn't say that.
All right, I'll pay you tomorrow.
You may not be around tomorrow.
Peavy!
There's your bill, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Thank you, Peavy.
Yes.
Say, you're pretty good.
I think so.
You first.
from now on, you're in charge.
Okay. I guess I am. Why don't you wait here while I case the joint?
Case the joint?
Find out where the vaults are.
Maybe I better go with you.
Well, that's where the shooting may take place. That's the first place the Whistling Bandit will go.
Oh? Well, maybe I better stay here. After all, you're in charge.
Oh, that's the kind of cooperation I like.
If you want me, I'll be behind the counter here. No sense in making a target out of myself.
Very wise.
Rafferty, what are you doing?
Lupkin.
Rafferty. Is he here yet?
He'll be here any minute.
What's that?
Noise.
Maybe I ought to go outside and look for him.
Very, very wise.
Yeah, I thought so.
Now, Rafferty, I trust you.
Turn around. Start backing toward that safe.
You're going to lock me in the safe?
Keep backing.
You know, I'm still armed. I've got a tear gas bomb.
Yeah, but you don't know how to use it. Keep backing.
Gildersleeve, that was real clever, breaking that window and setting off that burglar alarm.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Real fast thinking.
Well, you gave me a job to do, and I did it.
Thanks to you, Commissioner, we have the Whistling Bandit where we want him.
He didn't fool me for one minute. Sucker.
Gildersleeve, we'd like a picture for the press. Now, would you mind demonstrating to me exactly how you routed the bandit?
Yeah, oh, I'd be glad to, Mr. Mayor. Would you hand me one of those tear gas bombs in that box there? Right, thank you. Now, Rafferty was coming toward me, and all I had was this tear gas bomb. And I said, now, Rafferty, I'll let you have it.
Hold it. Smile.
Gildersleeve! Sorry, Mr. Mayor.